Great. Thank you very much, Linda. As Linda mentioned, I'm Chris Houchens, and I'm pleased to have a few moments this afternoon to tell you about the mission, the goals, and the strategic priorities for BARDA's Division of Chemical, Biological, Radiological, Nuclear, Medical Countermeasures, or CBRN MCMs. I'm honored to lead an extraordinary group of program managers, subject matter experts, and contractors as we engage with you, our industry partners and stakeholders, to develop and procure medical countermeasures to address a wide range of CBRN threats. As you heard from Assistant Secretary O'Connell earlier this morning, ASPR's mission is to assist the country in preparing for, responding to, and recovering from public health emergencies and natural disasters. And as my BARDA colleagues described earlier, BARDA supports the ASPR mission by partnering with industry to advance the research and development of medical countermeasures such as diagnostics, vaccines, and therapeutics against a range of CBRN, pandemic influenza, and emerging infectious disease threats. I'm going to use the next few minutes to tell you about how BARDA works with our colleagues across BARDA to form innovative public partner, private partnerships with the dedicated industry partners to develop and make available novel, safe, and effective MCMs by utilizing flexible authorities, multi-year funding, subject matter expertise, and core services in order to reduce risk and accelerate product development. I would be remiss if I did not mention BARDA's strategic plan, which you've heard about this morning, but I want to talk about it as a frame-setting device to tell you more about how it fits within BARDA's mission space and CBRN's mission space. You've heard a lot about preparedness, response, partnerships, and workforce, the goals of BARDA's strategic plan over the next few days, and how these strategic goals are woven into everything we do every day here at BARDA to accomplish our mission. This plan is critical as it's meant to clearly articulate our mission and vision to BARDA stakeholders in government, industry, and public health to ensure alignment across the MCM research and development ecosystem. And it also builds on what BARDA has learned and accomplished over the last 17 years while establishing how we will work with our partners in the private sector and government partners to further protect the nation against a wide range of threats to national health security. Our BARDA and CBRN is simple. Establish the technologies and capabilities to respond to any natural or intentional CBRN health security threat, which could be a bacterial viral threat agent, a hazardous chemical, a radiological dispersal event, or nuclear detonation. Our three-pronged approach is synchronized with many of the objectives of the BARDA strategic plan, including developing capabilities to rapidly mitigate the medical consequences of known and unknown threats, investing in sustainable MCM development, production, and administration technologies, and protecting all populations comprehensively and equitably. When we think of chemical, biological, radiological, nuclear threats, numerous real-world examples come to mind. The opioid crisis that claimed over 100,000 American lives in 2022. Multi-drug-resistant bacteria that can't be treated with current antibiotics. The constant and existential threat posed by nuclear weapons. The anthrax attacks in 2001. Chemical weapons that have been used around the world like nerve agents, pharmaceutical-based agents, phosgene, cyanide, and sarin gas, viral hemorrhagic fever outbreaks that repeatedly occur in Africa, radioactive disasters like the Fukushima Daiichi accident in Japan, and secondary drug-resistant bacterial and fungal infections that complicate our responses to any of these CBRN threats. These are just some of the threats for which CBRN has a responsibility to develop and make available medical countermeasures to ensure that our nation is well prepared to effectively respond to all threats to national health security. Over the past year alone, CBRN has made excellent progress towards accomplishing the goals of the BARDA strategic plan. To name a few, we obligated nearly $1.5 billion to new and existing partnerships to advance the development and procurement of medical countermeasures to ensure that we're well prepared to respond to current and future health security threats. We supported 7 responses to viral outbreaks, the global AMR crisis, the wildfires in Maui, and the COVID-19 and Mpox responses. And our partnerships also led to the FDA approval, licensure, or clearance of 7 products that are within our CBRN portfolio. Critically, it was our dynamic CBRN team, which now includes over 90 of the most dedicated, talented, and professional federal employees and subject matter experts that work tirelessly with our colleagues across BARDA, the U.S. government, and industry that allowed us to accomplish these goals. I mentioned that our overall goal is to develop sustainable solutions to address a wide range of national health security threats that can affect numerous populations. I will spend the next few minutes telling you how we plan to accomplish this goal by focusing our efforts on 6 strategic priorities within CBRN. Goal number 1 is to invest in the development of host-directed, threat-agnostic medical countermeasures capable of addressing a range of CBRN threats by treating the injuries caused by the threats rather than targeting the threats themselves. Despite the substantial difference in the mechanism of action among biological, chemical, radiological, nuclear threats, they often result in a common set of injuries and pathologies. As such, host-directed countermeasures that focus on treating the symptoms rather than the threats themselves have the potential to be effective across the spectrum of current CBRN threats, while also providing capabilities to rapidly and effectively respond to new and emerging threats in the future. Other efforts we are leading in this space include the development and utilization of microphysiological systems to systematically identify common pathological outcomes following the exposure to a range of threats. This will help us to discover and develop novel cellular targets and host-directed medical countermeasures with broad-spectrum activities that have the potential to address multiple CBRN threats, both known and unknown. Goal number 2 is to support the development of flexible and agile platform technologies that offer the capability to redirect MCM development and delivery capabilities and efforts from known priority threat agents to unknown emerging threats in the future. We will continue to build on our successful decade of investing in platform capabilities and taking those products to licensure, as we have done for numerous products such as monoclonal antibodies to treat Ebola Zaire and vaccines for smallpox, Ebola, and COVID-19. It is important to note that by working closely and collaboratively with our partners in the FDA to obtain regulatory approval of products developed using platform approaches, we give regulators greater confidence in the safety and efficacy of those capabilities that could lead to accelerated approval of products against future threats. We are also investing in novel plug-and-play technologies that will allow us to rapidly pivot to new threats. For example, our Flexible and Strategic Therapeutics, or FASTX, program is advancing the development of next-generation nucleic acid-based and antibody-like therapeutic platforms against a range of viral threat agents. Additionally, given the success of mRNA vaccines and changing the course of the COVID-19 pandemic, we're also supporting advanced development of next-generation RNA-based vaccines as part of our long-standing partnership with the DoD Joint Program Executive Office for CBRN Defense. I hope that you can join our breakout sessions tomorrow to learn more about these exciting programs. Our third goal is supporting the development and establishment of flexible technologies for MCM manufacturing, which is critical to build national resilience and strengthening preparedness to address known threats while preparing to respond rapidly and effectively to future yet currently unknown threats. By investing in flexible manufacturing capabilities and technologies, we can bring products closer to end users and promote a stable infrastructure and robust supply chain. In addition, incorporating artificial intelligence and machine learning approaches and technologies throughout the MCM development process ensures that we can effectively optimize the discovery, development, manufacture, and delivery of safe and effective diagnostics, vaccines, and therapeutics against a wide range of threats to the nation. A fourth pillar that we will continue to focus on is stakeholder and end-user engagement to ensure that MCMs are readily accessible and user-friendly. This is a critical component of MCM development, especially for products that will be used during public health emergencies and mass casualty events. To accomplish this, we will engage with the stakeholders and end users who use our products in the field, whether they're patients, first responders, emergency care personnel, or specialists to identify their MCM needs and requirements. We will also work closely with our interagency partners to provide subject matter expertise to support new requirements for existing and emerging threats. And we will work with our public health stakeholders and end users to develop and publish science-based guidance and protocols to enable emergency and healthcare personnel to safely and effectively respond to biological, chemical, radiological, and nuclear threat agents. The fifth priority of CBRN is improving the utility and long-term sustainability of all MCMs that we develop. Long-term sustainability is critical in ensuring MCM availability during public health emergencies and mass casualty events, which is very well articulated by Dr. Johnson earlier this morning. Where possible, we will invest in the development of MCMs that are already FDA approved and are available in the commercial marketplace so they can be redirected to new uses to address CBRN threats. This facilitates sustainability of those medical countermeasures and improves their accessibility to first responders and physicians in the event of an emergency. For many of our products with commercial uses, we will employ vendor-managed inventory as we have for many years now, with stock rotation to ensure their availability at all times while saving taxpayer dollars that can be invested in the development of new medical countermeasures against other threat agents. CBRN also invests in medical countermeasures to prevent and treat illnesses caused by potential biothreat agents like anthrax, smallpox, and Ebola that lack commercial markets and are more challenging to sustain. To enhance the sustainability of such products, we will support studies and novel approaches to extend the shelf life that improve the concept of and improve the concept of operations of products that we stockpile to extend and expand our preparedness posture as much as possible. By focusing our MCM utility, by focusing our efforts on MCM utility and supporting the integration of products into routine healthcare, our goal is to ensure that the MCMs that we have developed have long-term availability and sustainability to the end users who need them, when they need them, and where they need them. Lastly, goal six is squarely in line with the ASPR and BARDA strategic objectives to protect all members of our communities against an evolving threat landscape by ensuring our communities against an evolving, by ensuring that MCMs to treat the outcomes caused by CBRN threats are suitable for diverse patient populations in varied healthcare settings. We remain committed to supporting post-marketing commitments and requirements to facilitate label expansion for pediatric or older populations by ensuring that clinical trials are conducted in the appropriate populations. We are also committed to working closely with our industry and global partners to establish clinical trial protocols in the appropriate locations prior to an outbreak so patients can enroll in clinical trials as soon as an outbreak begins. And finally, availability of healthcare resources is a critical consideration during public health emergency or mass casualty incidences. We will leverage our partnerships with rural healthcare and military communities to understand the limitations associated with treating sick and injured patients in resource-limited environments and apply those insights to the development of next-generation products that require less training and are fit for purpose based on where and how they will be used. I hope that I've been able to clearly highlight for you some of CBRN's strategic priorities and goals for the coming years. While my time was limited today, We're excited to share even more details about CBRN priorities with you tomorrow at 9 o'clock, where the CBRN program leads will discuss our branch and threat-specific priorities and goals. We also look forward to engaging with you and learning more about your technologies and the networking opportunities scheduled for both today and later tomorrow. In addition, you will have an opportunity to learn more about many of our other efforts led by members of the CBRN team during these sessions here tomorrow. Thank you for the opportunity to share with you our mission, goals, and priorities with you, and I look forward to engaging with you through the next 2 days. Thank you very much.